Fantastic to be here. It gave me such a thrill walking around the corner. So I was driven by the wind, but eyes dripping as I wandered around the corner. British Museum and saw the boss. Fantastic. What a thrill indeed. So Alan talked about the policies. Yeah, there they are. But, you know, are they being implemented in schools? Well, the truth is, no, they're actually not. So my job is to encourage all teachers to implement all these policies and get them working in school by celebrating LGBT History Month. That is why we're here. And my reason for starting this work 5 years ago was, God, this stage is so gay. This room, this lecture theatre is so gay. Right, being used, I think I might be using it in the right context this afternoon, I dare say. But it's not used in the right way in schools, as you all know. And that was my starting point, really. So now, my job role, I teach music in my school. I'm also a head of year. And after lots of negotiation with my head teacher, she's allowed me a couple of days per term to go out now and train staff in other schools, even to the point of getting to PGCE students, which I think is the next best thing where we need to go. And those PGCE students were amazing, full of life, full of brand new ideas. And they've said to me, well, look, your celebration's next year. Why don't you do a mini pride in your courtyard? I was like, great, what a fantastic idea. So I am going to steal those ideas from the young people. Right, here we go. This is what we've achieved as a school so far. This is after 5 years. And you have to remember that you've got to start really, really small. You can't just wander in to a year 11 lesson and start talking about lesbians. You're just going to get laughed and joked and taunted out of that room. You can't do it. You must start really, really small. So I was new in post of head of year, which gave me, you know, a nice bit of autonomy to do what I wanted in my assemblies. And that's where I started. And then just did one project with my year sevens, all my year seven classes, and we learnt run away, turn away, run away. And we watched Jimmy Somerville being beaten up by a few boys, and we watched his parents throw him out. You know, was that the right thing to do? You know, opened up the lines of discussion. So 5 years on, where we're at now? Students empowered to report the bullying, because that was the problem. No one dare say anything about it at all. So now what we've done, got our referral pads reprinted. There's a box there, so if it's refusal to obey instructions, fighting, now there's one for homophobia. So the kids are sanctioned now. They are sent home and they are excluded, you know, and the statistics have gone right down. That stopped a lot of the bullying that was going on around the school. Permanent display, you've got to have that, you've got to have it. And, oh, yes, thank you. You've got to have it. If you're trying to get a message across, you've got to have some visual representation somewhere along the line. It amazes me. I've been into a few schools recently and I've said to them, where is your school code? Where is it? There doesn't seem to be anything on your walls. And like, well, I don't think we actually have a school code. Like, what? Well, how can you tell the students how you want them to behave if you have no code? You need that on the wall to, when they do something that's not acceptable, to point straight to it. It's a very simple process. So encourage all teachers, have that school code on your wall. Educate the students and the staff. Well, I don't mind having rows with kids about this sort of thing because that's part of my job, I think, is to educate, you know, and change their opinions. But I find it really difficult sometimes is changing the opinions of staff. It makes me feel very, very uncomfortable, but you have to do it. This is what I mean. Get your groundwork done first. Make sure your policies are in place. Make sure your head teacher's on side. Get some time in a staff meeting to talk to staff about it and have those open discussions before you start this kind of work. You must lay the foundations before you start. Message goes out to parents in the community. That's always brilliant. I love that. I have to say, don't get any complaints from parents anymore. And we only got three or four in the first instance, which is just a message in a diary saying, I don't want my child to take part in these activities. You know, I say, well, you know, you come into the school then, take your kid out of that lesson, then bring them back later on. Oh, no, not doing that. You know, before you know it, all the kids in there and they're all learning. So you've just got to face these things head on. Raise awareness through publicity. I love publicity. Anything I'm asked to do, anywhere I'm asked to speak, anything I'm asked to write, I will always go. The bigger the audience, the better. We need to get these messages out there. Safe zone. Schools should be safe communities for everybody, shouldn't they? It's amazing how they're not, you know, and it's amazing how lots of schools will celebrate Black History Month. I think every school celebrates Black History Month, but yet they won't celebrate LGBT History Month. It's weird. And I've had several conversations with my kids that go, oh, miss, you're trying to make us gay by doing this work. No, we're not trying to make you gay. Just, do we all turn black in Black History Month? No, we don't. Do we all turn Turkish in Turkish History Month? No, we don't, right? It's to raise awareness and look at the histories of LGBT people. Celebrate. Can't stand the word tolerate. Don't ever say it to me. I will walk off in disgust. Right, celebrate. That's what we do. We celebrate the lives of LGBT people. And we're creating a safe zone for everybody. You know, everyone should feel comfortable. This is what I mean about publicity. It's great. Since I started doing this work, there's obviously a need for this. And people obviously want to do it, but are a little bit scared to do it. So I just think it's really good. So when I'm asked, Teachers TV came to us and said, would you mind coming out on TV? I was like, well, no, come on, let's do it, let's bring it on. And another member of staff who's here today also was encouraged to come out. He felt really safe to come out too in school, so was also prepared to be on that TV programme. And that was the wonderful thing about our school. These are some of the projects that we've done over the last few years. IT, Alan Turing, fantastic story. Kids don't believe in oppression of any kind. So any story like that you can tell them, brilliant. I mean, I love to make up the story. I'm not sure it's actually true, because he killed himself with a poisoned apple, yeah? And because he was part of inventing a computer, I like to tell them that's the symbol when he took the bite for Apple Mac computers. The rainbow and the thing, like, oh my God! We wouldn't have the computers if it wasn't for gay people, so I quite like to make that story up. Love it. Sold. Then they're big on LGBT. Right. Science. Transbiology. Lots of work there. Humanities. Music. There's just a plethora of music. You cannot go wrong with that at all. D&T made a rainbow flag. I'll be going into detail more later on. We've got a teacher's surgery later on between 5 and 6. I'll be showing you more pictures and giving you more ideas for resources if you want to pop along to that session. MFL played the film Mavie on Rose, which is a fantastic film, and it's about a young boy who grows up who wears girls' clothes, and it's just about how the family and the community deal with that. This year as well, Extra Literacy even joined. I was really surprised about how different sections of the school are taking on an LGBT project each year. So it's got did some comprehension on a story called Seamlessly Fake. Bringing the whole school together. This is the most amazing bit. When you've done a month of celebrations, to get everybody in the same room and to celebrate what you've done, it was, for me, the most euphoric thing we've ever done. Now, this was a couple of years ago, Miss Fontaine came to perform, and it was such a magnificent moment, because she came in and stood at the front and said, I'm currently a lesbian, and the kids were going, What? Don't get it at all. Looking around. And that's not what Miss told us. We don't understand this. Went, I'm currently transitioning. Then, we've heard of that. We've done that in science. Yes. We get it. Oh. And then she started to sing and got the crowd going. It was utter silence, first of all. And then they got more into it. And within like a minute, everyone was up, she was working the crowd, going round there. It was an amazing moment. And straight after that, loads of kids came running up to me. I want to be part of the workshop this afternoon. Oh, my goodness. And these were kids that had previously been homophobic, who I'd previously had rows with in the corridors about the work we were doing. And that's why role models are so important to get into schools. This year, I wanted to get the staff on side, so I asked the staff if they wouldn't mind coming up and singing to the whole of the school. And about 60 members of staff got up and we all sang, Go West, life is peaceful there. And it was just an amazing moment. It sent the message to the kids that all the staff were on side, and it was a beautiful moment. So I encourage all of you to begin and reap the benefits in your workplace and your schools of this work. Thank you very much for listening.